Hello, in this video, I'd like to talk about how to use Wolfram Cloud and Mathematica to do some calculations. This is just a very quick introduction to it. A little bit more comprehensive introduction could be found in this document under the course resources. So to go to Wolfram Cloud, you can use this link or just simply type wolframcloud.com. And the first time you log in, you won't see this screen. You will likely see a screen that looks more like this. And then you'll have to sign up. But the account should be free, and you just have to use you can use your LA Mission College email. Or you can use your personal email, it doesn't really matter. So I'm just going to log in here. Okay, so when you log in, this is what you see. You can open one of your older NB files. NB stands for notebook. So, or you can start a new one. So, if we start a new notebook, this is the screen we get. Okay, so over here we have some help. Documentation allows you to look for commands for Mathematica. For example, if you're interested in, let's say, visualization and graphics, let's say function visualization, here are the Mathematica options you could use. Let's say we're interested in 3D plots. These are a couple of functions you can use for 3D plotting. And here are some examples you can look for. It's very easy to copy the examples. You just click on it. And it's copied, and then over here is where we mostly work with commands. So I can close this out here, and all I have to do is right-click paste here, or just Control V to paste the command which we copied. Now to execute the command, we have to hold the Shift key and then hit Enter. We could do that, or we can choose Evaluate, Evaluate Cell. And so this right here is a cell, the small one which we entered. This is the input cell. And over here, this right here is the output cell. And in the output cell, we have our 3D plot, as you can see. Once we have our 3D plot, we do have a couple of images, options. We can copy it, or we can save the image, as you can see, into our files. And we can then, in fact, enter it into Microsoft Word later on if we wanted to have a report on this. Each input has a line. As you can see, this says LN1, which means the first input, and this is the OUT1, which means this is the output referring to the input one. So let's say we want to do something basic like addition. Let's do 2 + 3. You can see we have the input 2 and then output 2. So this is the output that was generated based on the second input. We actually have access to these outputs. These are all these outputs are saved into a variable which can be accessed by hitting percent and then the output number. So let's say percent 2. Percent 2 refers to this output of the second input. And since that's 5, it outputs 5. So in fact, we can say take that and then add another number, let's say 7, right? And so now we have added 5 + 7, so 12. Those are just the basic addition functions. Now, Mathematica does have quite a lot of built-in, as you noticed, functions. And I will go over some of the basic things at the moment, but a little bit more comprehensive video should follow. So when we do any sort of calculations, let's say we do 12 divided by 5, we get an a fraction. If we want a numerical approximation, if we want a decimal approximation, we use the n function. We can say n of 12 over 5. We could do it this way, or we could do, as you see, evaluate numerically or approximate the fifth output. So that's also gives us 2.4. If we want, we can actually specify how many digits we want the approximation approximation's accuracy. So for that, let's use the square root function. This is the square root of, let's say, 5. So you can see it gives us the actual value. If we want the approximation of that, we could do a nested nested functions like this, and so it gives us the square root of 5 approximated, looks like, up to 5 digits. Now if we want more, what we could do is let's copy this. I'm just gonna right click here. It looks like right click doesn't work, so I'm just gonna do Control C to copy and then do Control V to paste. So notice the way I did that is I just clicked here to copy. All right, and then what we want to do is put a comma here and say, let's say I want it accurate up to 20 digits, so I get my 20 digits. So you just specify how many digits you want the accuracy to be. So that's the approximation function there. Trigonometric functions, in general, as you noticed, built-in Mathematica functions always start with a capital letter. Lowercase letters are used for variables. Capital letters are for constants. For example, pi is also a constant. And if we want the approximation of that, let's say we want it up to 50 digits. There it is. Now, if we want to do some trick, we can use the built-in functions there. Notice I'm using brackets, never parentheses. This is important. In general, we use brackets to represent the parentheses that the parentheses of functions. Okay. So we can also define our own functions. This is a bit arcane looking, but here we go. So the way it looks is if we want to do f of x, we first specify the independent variable by putting an underline next to it, then colon equals to specify that we're doing a function. And then at this point I could do, let's say, 2 times sine of 3x. That's it. So this is now a function. We can call it by just sort of saying f of x, again, using brackets, not parentheses. It tells us that that's the function we have. At this point, we can evaluate normally. Like, for example, we want to do f of pi. It'll evaluate this function. If we wanted to, we didn't have to necessarily refer it to f of x. We can also refer to this as the 15th output by using percent 5. And then we could do evaluations in the following way. We can say percent 15, excuse me. And then we do forward slash dot. And then we say, okay, I want x to be, let's say, 2 pi. As you can see, what this does is it takes 2 pi and plugs it into the 15th output. This phrase here, forward slash dot, it means evaluate at, and then we say plug in x, 2 pi for x, excuse me, into this function. Right, so that's what that means. Let me give you a simpler example. Let's say we have 3x minus 5, right? We want to plug in a value for x. We do forward slash dot and we say x, and then to do this arrow, by the way, you do dash and then the larger than symbol, this symbol. When you put them together, it turns it into an arrow automatically. So we can do, let's say we want to plug in 2 there, again shift enter, and now as you can see it has plugged into 3x minus 5. Alternatively, we could have defined a function g of x as 3x minus 5, and then plugged in a 2 by just calling the function like this, g of 2. Okay, now if we want to plot these, the way you do this is use the plot function, all right? And we say, what do we want to plot? Let's say we want to plot the g of x, And we also specify what the independent variable is, and we want to plot it from, let's say, from negative 5 to 5. Okay, so this all has to be correct. We have to use curly braces and as well as brackets here. So these brackets refer to the plot function, and then it calls, it has two arguments, g of x, and then the function we're graphing, and then basically the domain with the independent variable. All right, let's plot that. There we go. The plot actually has quite a lot of other features which you can enter as part of several different arguments. You can change colors, you can specify the range, you do all sorts of things with this feature. And you can, to find out more, you can just go to documentation and you can search for plot over here. So you can just type plot and then it'll tell you the documentation for plot and all sorts of other options as far as like basic examples are concerned, and then features like how to manipulate axes, colors, meshing. It's quite a lot of stuff here that you can definitely work with. Okay, so that's just some basics of plotting, very basics. We'll do 3D plotting later, and you can see that more in detail in the file I provided for you right here. Now, just a quick guide to solving equations. So let's say we have a basic equation like 2x minus 5 is equal to 10, right? So the way you do this is use the solve function. You enter the equation. Now, what's important is you got to use double equal signs for equations in general, because otherwise the single equal sign means you're doing an assignment. And then we just specify the variable for which we are solving. And we have the solution, it's 15 over 2. Okay. So this will conclude just the very, 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 very basics of using Mathematica. You can save your file by giving it a name on top here, and then just hit enter. And then you can refer to this by ultimately going into your cloud files, and it should be available in the list here of files that we just created. Okay, there it is. And so you can always recall it. These can also be downloaded and shared. I wish you good luck and enjoy learning Mathematica. If this is your first time, it's a very powerful tool. It is used in the industry quite a bit. It will be used in this class as well. Good luck.